So I just wanted to ask, what actually inspired you to do a project on deepfakes?
Yeah, that's a good question. So I've been researching computer vision and artificial intelligence for several years now. And there was a competition over the summer, which I saw or heard of, called the Deepfake Detection Challenge. And that was made by a bunch of companies at like Facebook, Microsoft, AWS, Amazon, a whole bunch of companies and universities on, it was a competition with a $1 million prize of who can detect deepfakes the best. And I didn't enter, but I took the top performing methods out of those and I improved them by a factor of 10 in terms of speed to allow them to be applicable at scale.
And it's common enough in computer programming to build on work that other people done. And it sounds like you've done a great build on top of the work of these top five. If there's another big challenge from Amazon and Microsoft, do you think you'll enter?
Yeah, definitely. I'd like to. I mean, you know, I don't know whether I'd win or not, but it's always fun to try.
Well, you won one thing, so you never know. It could be more to follow there. And is computer science and that kind of thing, is that what you think you're going to pursue in the future?
Yeah, it's been, you know, just it's been in my life since I was like 4 or 5. I've had a computer. I mean, and then when I was 9, I started properly programming and teaching myself to code. That's my thing. Yeah.
And is it entirely self-taught, or have you found other groups or anything like that you've worked with?
Yeah, it's entirely self-taught, except, you know, with the internet, you've always got tutorials and, you know, how-tos. I started with that, and then you eventually get to a point where you can just start exploring topics in and of your own volition, pretty much.
Yeah, and
no help required.
It's something that you do outside of school work. You're quite interested in it as a hobby.
Yeah, yeah, it takes up most of my time, I'd say.
Is there anything else that you've built or anything that you're quite proud of?
Yeah, this is my 5th year entering BT Young Scientist. I've got 4 other projects, not even all about AI. I've got 2 other ones on AI and 2 other ones in biology. So yeah, I do a fair bit of mini projects every now and then I do a big BT Young Scientist every year.
And it was great to see as well. One of the heads of the judging panel, Leonard Hobbs, said they had noticed your 5 years worth of projects. They hadn't gone unnoticed, and they were well aware of your prowess there.
Yeah, he was one of my judges in the previous years, and he'd recognized me, and I'm so grateful for having him as one of my judges. It was truly spectacular talking with him.
Yeah. And it's leaving CERT, hopefully, whatever's going to happen there next for you, is it? And then have you got plans for after school?
Yeah, I'm going to go to college and, you know, I'm deciding between commercial endeavors and academia, and I'm going to try and balance those two equally. But yeah, I want to become an entrepreneur eventually and do the whole tech path.
And being coming from, are you from Bandon or are you from around Bandon?
I've lived in Bandon pretty much my whole life. So yeah, I'm properly from Bandon.
So you said earlier in your interview with the award ceremony that you count the likes of the Collison brothers as kind of idols, and they come from that west side of Ireland, and but now they're based in Silicon Valley. Would you see yourself kind of continue on in Ireland? Do you think there's opportunities enough in Ireland, or would you go further?
Ireland is a perfect place for tech. It's fabulous. I mean, everyone always, you know, the media always says Silicon Valley, but Ireland is just good at, like, it's perfect. And yes, the Collison brothers are definitely idols of mine.
Yeah, and sure, they came back here. Stripe has plenty of offices and workers here, so.
Yeah, I've actually had a tour of their Dublin office. I won their award last year at BT. It was a fantastic experience.
And do you feel, as part of the kind of the BT Young Scientist alumni, you've been participating for years now, there's a community there as well, is there? Do you make use of that? Have you got connections there?
Oh, yeah. Oh, it's one of the best things about BT is just meeting like-minded individuals and, you know, talking ideas with them. They're all great, you know, bouncing boards for thoughts that I'm having. So, you know, many of my friends are from BT. It's just a great community.
That's so good to hear. I hope you've enjoyed your time as well. I'm sure it was a bit tricky this year with working through lockdowns and the pandemic and everything.
Yeah, I'm, you know, good at computers, but BT has done a fabulous job at converting this exhibition to, you know, an online thing. It was just really, really stress-free. It was amazing. Well done to them.
Yeah, absolutely. And it was great to see Mary get the nod earlier today in the award ceremony. And then, like, as part of all the things that you've gone through, do you feel a bit, like, sad to say goodbye to Beating Scientists? Will this be your last?
Yeah. It is unfortunate. I'm not allowed to enter again. And of course, I'm in sixth year, so I can't anyway. But it's a good way to top off a long run at BT. I'm sad to see it go, but, you know, it's treated me well. And I'm happy. I'm guessing I come back next year to give a speech or something. So that's going to be nostalgic. It is a bit sad, sure. But I'm pretty much filled to the brim with happiness at the moment.
And to think of what could happen between this year and next, considering where we were at this time last year.
Yeah. Wow. It's been a big year, and I suspect this year is going to be even bigger.
Well, definitely for you. You're on a roll now. You're going out on a high, and you'll be going onto UC. So best of luck, and thanks so much for talking to me today.
Thank you so much. It was a pleasure talking with you.
It's great. And we actually had eyes on your project ourselves. We definitely had you pegged as one to watch. So to see one of the ones that we were looking at take the top prize. So congratulations.